الرسول إلى أهل روميا بركته علينا أمين. إذن ما هو فضل اليهودي أو ما هي منفعة الختان؟ عظيم على كل واحد. أما أولا فلأنهم استؤمنوا على أقوال الله، فماذا إن كان قوم لم يؤمنوا؟ أفلعل عدم أمانتهم يبطل أمانة الله؟ حاشا، بل ليكن الله صادقا وكل إنسان كاذبا، كما هو مكتوب لكي تتبرر في كلامك وتغلب متى حكم. ولكن إن كان ظلمنا يثبت بر الله فماذا نقول؟ ألعل الله الذي يغلب الغضب ظالم؟ قلت هذا بحسب الإنسان، حاشا، فكيف يدين الله العالم؟ فإن كان صدق الله قد ازداد بكذبه لمجده، فلماذا أدان أنا بعد خاطئ؟ وليس كما يفترى علينا وكما يزعم قوم أننا نقول لنفعل السيئات لتأتي الخيرات، أولئك الذين دينونتهم عادلة، فماذا لنا إذن؟ أنحن أفضل؟ كلا بت، لأننا قد سبقنا وشكونا أن اليهود واليونانيين أجمعين تحت الخطية، كما هو مكتوب أنه ليس بار ولا واحد، ليس من يفهم، ليس من يطلب الله، الجميع زاهوا وفسدوا معا، ليس من يعمل صلاحا، ليس ولا واحد. حجرتهم قبر مفتوح، قد مقروا بلسانهم سم الأفاعي تحت شفاههم. هؤلاء الذين أفواههم مملوءة لعنة ومرارة، أرجلهم سريعة إلى سفك الدم في طرقهم الانكسار والشقاوة، وطريق السلام لم يعرفوه، ليس خوف الله أمام عيونهم. ونحن نعلم أن كل ما يقوله الناموس فهو يكلم به الذين في الناموس، لكي يستد فهم كل واحد ويصير كل العالم تحت حكم الله، لأنه بأعمال الناموس كل ذي جسد لا يتبرر أمام الله، لأن بالناموس معرفة الخطيئة. وأما الآن فقد ظهر بر الله بدون الناموس مشهودا له من قبل الناموس والأنبياء، بر الله الذي بالإيمان بيسوع المسيح في جميع الذين يؤمنون، لأنه لا يوجد فرق، إذ الجميع أخطأوا وأعوزهم مجد الله متبررين مجانا بنعمته بالخلاص الذي بالمسيح يسوع، الذي سبق الله ووضعه كفارة بالإيمان بدمه لإظهار بره من أجل مغفرة الخطايا السالفة بإمهال الله، لكي يظهر بره في هذا الزمان الحاضر، ليكون بارا ويبرر من هو من الإيمان بيسوع المسيح. فأين الافتخار إذن؟ قد بطل. بأي ناموس؟ بناموس الأعمال؟ كلا، بل بناموس الإيمان. إذن نحسب أن الإنسان يتبرر بالإيمان بدون أعمال الناموس؟ أما الله لليهود فقط وليس للأمم أيضا؟ بل للأمم أيضا. فإذا إن كان الله واحدا وهو الذي سيبرر الختان بالإيمان والغرلة بالإيمان، أفنبطل الناموس بالإيمان؟ حاشا، بل نثبت الناموس. فماذا نقول عن إبراهيم إذ وجد أول أب حسب الجسد؟ لأنه إن كان إبراهيم قد تبرر بالأعمال فله فخر، ولكن ليس لدى الله، لأنه ماذا يقول الكتاب؟ آمن إبراهيم بالله فحسب له برا. نعمة الله الآن فتحل على أرواحنا يا أبي وإخوتي أبي.
The Catholic epistle from the first epistle of our teacher John, his blessing to be upon us all, amen, my beloved, that which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon and our hands have handled, concerning the word of life. The life was manifested, and we have seen and bear witness and declare to you that eternal life which was with the Father and was manifested to us, that which we have seen and heard we declare to you, that you may also have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. And these things we write to you, that your joy may be full. This is the message which we have heard from him and declare to you, that God is light and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, these things I write to you that you may not sin, and if anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he himself is a propitiation of, for our sins. Do not love the world nor the things which are in the world. The world shall pass away in all its desires, but he who does the will of God shall abide forever in them.
And the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Today is the 12th day of the blessed month of Kiev. May God begin it in goodness and renew it for us in peace and tranquility while our sins and iniquities are forgiven through the tender mercies of our Lord, O my Father and brethren, Amen. On this day, the commemoration of the honorable angel, my Archangel Michael, who is standing before God the Almighty, interceding on our behalf, saying, O you who are not prone to anger, do not be angry. O righteous one, have mercy on your creation. O you who is long-suffering, do not destroy the work of your hands. May his intercession be with us all. Amen. Every 12th day of every Coptic month, we commemorate Archangel Michael, and today is the 12th of Kiev, that's why we commemorate him and we ask on his prayer. On this day also the great father Abba Hedra, the Bishop of Aswan departed. His parents who were Christian raised him and taught him the fear of God since an early age. When he was 18 years old, his parents wanted him to marry one of his relatives, but he refused with the excuse that he was ill. That morning he went to church early, prayed with the congregation, asked the Lord Christ to reveal to him through the reading of the scripture what was his will for him. He heard what comforted him. When he left the church, he saw a deceased person was carried and on his way to the cemetery. He walked among the mourner, talking to himself, saying, "Listen, Hedra, it is not this one that died, but you yourself who did from this futile world." When they arrived at the cemetery and buried the departed, he did not go back to his home, but joined the monastery and lived among the monks. When his family and friend heard what he did, they went and told him, "In so doing, you have brought grief to us and have saddened your fiancé's heart." They added, "You can worship God in any place you desire." When they failed to change his mind, they went back with grief-filled hearts, for his separation. Henceforth, Saint Hedra went on in intense worship, asceticism, continuous fasting, uninterrupted prayer, and numerous metanias. He was a contemporary of Saint Pimen and became his disciple. Saint Hedra was guided by Amba Pimen's teaching and his good example. 8 years later, he asked to live solitary life in the desert. Amba Pimen asked him to read the biography of the great saint Abba Antony, the father of all monks, in order to learn how to fight the devil enemy Satan. When the elder allowed him, he went in the desert until he found the cave wherein he lived. He lived there for many years fighting the devil and his soldiers. The devil tempted him frequently. One time the devil appeared with a sword in his hand and wanted to cut off Amba Hedra's hand. The saint cried to the Lord and the devil disappeared at once. One day he left his cave, and when he came back, he found a huge dragon in the cave. He prayed to the Lord, saying, "My Lord and Master, it is your will for me to live with this beast, so be it." He then looked at the dragon and found that it was cut into 3 pieces. He was in continuous war with the devil, awakened during the night and unsettled during the day, but the Lord saved him from them all. The defiled spirit cried, saying, "Oh, to you, Hedra, for your prayer burned us and expelled us from the wilderness." He shut himself up in his cell. Nevertheless, they both, the sick and those who with evil spirits to him, he prayed over oil, anointed them with it, and they were healed immediately. Syrian monk came to him, asked about the clear issues in the scripture. He explained it all to them, and they marveled at his knowledge, saying, "We have been in many monasteries and mountains, visited teachers and philosophers, but we did not find anyone to explain these issues as Saint Hedra did." When the bishop of the city of Aswan departed, some of the people of the city went to the monastery. There they met the Syrian monks who praised Saint Hedra highly. They went to Saint Hedra and took him against his will and traveled to Alexandria Abba Theophilus, Pope of Alexandria, ordained him bishop over them. When he sat on his chair, he went on preaching to his people, teaching them the way of life. He performed many miracles and lived the rest of his life in good demeanor, then departed in peace. May his prayers be with us all. Amen. So, Sanhedra or Ambahedra is one of the great saints among the monks. And we saw how he lived the life, and he said, "It's me who died," and how he used to go to church and ask God to reveal to him his will through the scripture and the reading of the church. That's why we say, try to focus on the readings. Try to focus on the reading. Try to focus in the teaching. Because God will reveal to you his will through the reading of the church and through the prayers. So we come to the church to learn. We come to the church to know the will of God. So don't forget that. في هذا اليوم أيضا تذكر نياحة القديس يوحنا المعترف وهو أحد المعترفين المصريين. والمعترفون هم المؤمنون بالمسيح الذين احتملوا عذابات كثيرة من أجل إيمانهم بالمسيح وثبتوا، ولكن الله بحكمته السامية لم يسمح باستشهادهم وتم إطلاق سراحهم من السجون. ومنهم القديس يوحنا المصري، احتمل عذابات شديدة أيام الاضطهاد، قلعت عيناه وكويت بالنار حتى تلفته وطرح في النار ولم تؤذيه حتى أثار على عجاب الكثير بثبات إيمانه وقوة تحمله. مما كان يميز هذا القديس قوة ذاكرته، فقد حفظ أسفارا كاملة من الكتاب المقدس، وكان يستطيع أن يستعيد أي فقرة من الكتاب المقدس سواء من العهد القديم أو الجديد، وكانوا يتلوها بدقة كمن يقرأ في كتاب. ربنا يدينا نعمة حلوة، اللي يطلبها ياخدها. كان بيحفظ حاجات من الإنجيل ويسترجعها سهل جدا، كأنه سيرش إنجن، يعني كأنك أنت يعني مخه عامل زي الكمبيوتر كده، يدور على أي آية يجيبها ويقول لك الآية دي في السفر الفلاني. ولما أكمل جهاد وتنيح بسلام بركة صلاته تكون معنا أمين. وفيه أيضا من سنة 249 عقد مجمع بنية روميا، حضره 60 أسقفا و18 قصا وشماسا من علماء روميا برئاسة القديس كرنيليوس أسقف روميا لمحاكمة القس نوباتوس الذي ابتدع قائلا: من ينكر الإيمان وقت الاضطهاد لا تقبل توبته، معتمدا على قول معلمنا بولس الرسول: لأن الذين استنيروا مرة وذاقوا الموهبة السماوية وصاروا شركاء الروح القدس وذاقوا كلمة الله الصالحة وقوات الظهر الآتي وسقطوا، لا يمكن تجديدهم بالتوبة، إذ هم يسلبون لأنفسهم ابن الله ثانية ويشهرون. فوضح لهم الآباء بأن القديس بولس الرسول لم يكن هذا عن من يتوب، بل عن من أن يريد أن يكرر المعمودية بعد كل خطيئة، لأن المعمودية إنما تكون مرة واحدة. ولهذا استضاف الرسول قائلا: إذ هم يسلبون لأنفسهم ابن الله ثانية، يعني بهذا أنه لما كان الصلب قد حدث مرة واحدة هكذا تكون المعمودية واحدة. أما التوبة فبابها مفتوح لكل التائبين، وإلا فيكون كل من سقط في الخطيئة غير مقبول وغير تائب. ولو تاب فداود النبي أذن له إذن لم تقبل توبته، كذلك القديس بطرس الرسول لما أنكر فتاب وبكى لم تقبل توبته أيضا. وعلى هذا يكون باطلا حلول الروح القدس عليه، وباطلا أيضا تقليد رعاية كراف المسيح الناطقة، وتكون معمودية كل من اعتمد على يديه باطلة. وبالإجماع على حسب رأيه قد هلكوا، وهذا منتهى الجهل، بينما السيد المسيح قد أتى ليخلص الخطاة ويقتاده إلى التوبة. فلا تكن يا نوباتس عدوا لله ولنفسك وللإنسانية. وإذ لم يرجع نوباتس عن رأيه وبدعته الخطيرة، حرمه المجمع هو وكل من يقول بقوله، ثم نفاه المجمع بعدما منعه من الشركة. بركة صلاة هؤلاء الآباء القدسين تكون معنا، ولربنا المجد الدائم للأبد أمين.
ما كش فيهم انت رب حياتنا كلنا وخلصنا كلنا ورجعنا كلنا وشفقنا كلنا وقيامتنا كلنا
عاقران لأنه ليس شيء غير ممكن عند الله.
فقالت مريم للملاك: هوذا أنا أمة الرب، ليكن لي كقولك. فانصرف عنها الملاك. Second Sunday of the blessed month of Kiyak. And the month of Kiyak is a month of praises. And he has a very famous tune and praises. And we're all waiting for it. As we focus on the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ as the first step of our salvation, which happened in the fullness of time. And also we glorify Saint Mary, who was chosen to bear the incarnate word. Thus we call her the Mother of God, Theotokos. And as I told you last time, while we're praising and spending night for praising, ending by the liturgy, it reminds us of the second coming of Christ and how the Lord asks us to be watchful. So we are spending all the night watching and praising and hoping for the second coming of Christ. The reading of Sunday through the month of Kiyak is from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 1. And as you know, it's Annunciation, Visitation, Birth. First, the Annunciation was the Annunciation to Archangel Gabriel to Zechariah. And then today, the Annunciation of Archangel Gabriel to St. Mary. Third is the Visitation of St. Mary to Elizabeth. And then the birth of St. John the Baptist, and finally the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, which came in the 29th days of Kiyak. The nativity event is full of divine and heavenly appearance of angels, and also full of praises. That's why during the reading of the month of Kiyak, we will hear the praises of Saint Mary, the praises of Zechariah, the praises of the angels, the praises of Simon, the priest, and also the angel when he praised Saint Mary, and Elizabeth when also she praised Saint Mary. And praises elevates us into God's presence. As the Bible said, God inhabits in the presence, in the praises of His people. So when we praise God, we feel His presence. I don't know, I hope those who came yesterday to the Kiyak praises share with you their feeling. How did they feel while they're praising? We're in heaven. So again, I encourage all of you, we are in the half of it, 2 weeks already passed, and we have only 2 weeks. So next Friday we'll have overnight praises from 11 to 5:30 in the morning. I hope all of you will plan for it and will come. And this is a Christmas break, so you can come and spend the night praising. And this is a different experience. I hope we can all have it. Also on Saturday, as usual, we start Vesper at 6 p.m., followed by the praises ending about 9:30, so I hope also we can plan for it. Really, this fast, we get closer to God through praises and giving thanks. So try not to miss this opportunity. Praise Him and exalt Him above all, forever. praise him and exalt him above all forever. Last time, in the first Sunday, we learned to praise him because he always remembers his promises and have favor on his people. As we said, Zacharias means God remembers, Elizabeth means God promise, and John means God's favor. So God remembering his promises and have favor or has favor on his people. And we learned this verse, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid, for your prayers is heard. Every time we pray, your prayer is heard. So God always gives the right gift in the right time. And he always gives us what we need, not what we want. So let us praise him and exalt him above all forever. Today's reading is the annunciation of Archangel Gabriel to Saint Mary. And he said, rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. How a nice greeting. But this was like unusual greeting for someone to be greeted like that. So she was troubled. What is that? And he continued and said, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and he shall call his name Jesus. Do you know what the meaning of Jesus? Jesus means?
Savior.
And when Saint Mary asked him, how can I have that? I'm a virgin. I have no man. He said, the Holy Spirit will dwell on you, and the power of God will overshadow you, that whoever will born of you will be called holy, the Son of God. And also Elizabeth is pregnant in her old age. For with God, nothing will be impossible. That's why we praise him and exalt him above all, because with him, nothing is. He is the Almighty. Okay? So we praise him and exalt him above all, because he is Almighty. Nothing is impossible for him, and with him everything will be possible. So let us praise him and exalt him above all forever. So let us praise him and exalt him above all forever, because he always remembers his promises and his favor on his people. And also let us praise him and exalt him because he is Emmanuel. He is Emmanuel. God is with. Do you know the meaning of Emmanuel? God is with us. So let us praise him, because God the Almighty, the Creator, came and be within us. Emmanuel, our God, is in our midst. Emmanuel ilahna fi wasatna. He's Emmanuel. Let us praise him. Because when we are in front of God, when we have God in our midst, the most thing that appropriate for him is to praise him. To give him thanks, to say, holy, holy, holy Lord of hosts. Let us praise him and exalt him, because he is Emmanuel, God is with us. And let us praise him and exalt him above all, because he is Jesus. He is our Savior. He is our Redeemer. He is the one who forgave our sins through the shedding of his blood on the cross and gave us eternal life through his resurrection from the dead. And also let us praise his mother, Saint Mary, with Archangel Gabriel, saying, hail to you, O full of grace, the Lord is with you, blessed are you among the women. Second message for today is don't afraid. Don't be afraid. Last week, the angel said to Zacharias, don't be afraid, for your prayer is heard. And today he said, don't be afraid, the Lord is with you. I don't know how many of us is afraid or concerned about something. If you're concerned about something, or if you're afraid, do not be afraid. The Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. And as David said, If the Lord is with me, whom shall I afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Of whom shall I fear? الرب نوري وخلاصي ممن أخاف. الرب حسن حياتي ممن أرتعب. The Lord is with you. How an encouraging message. How a beautiful message for all of us today. Do not be afraid. The Lord is with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. And He will not let your foot be slumbered. Do not be afraid. The Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. That means you are blessed. As we say to Saint Mary. Blessed are you, O full of grace. The Lord is with you. So if the Lord is with us, we are blessed. We are blessed. We are blessed with many blessings. We are blessed with strength and deliverance. We are blessed with victory and salvation. We are blessed with success in everything. And we are blessed with care and protection. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. When David wants to defeat Goliath, Saul told him, "What are you doing? You're a little boy. How can you stand in front of this huge man? You can't do it." What was the answer of David to him? "The Lord who delivered me from the paw of his lion and from the paw of the bear, He will deliver me from the hand of this Palestinian." And Saul said to David, "Go and the Lord be with you." The Lord who delivered me, Emmanuel, Jesus, my Savior is with me. I will not fear anything. He is the strength, the source of my strength. And He always delivers. He always delivers. الرب الذي أنقذني من يد الأسد ومن يد الدب هو ينقذني من يد هذا الفلسطيني. فقال شاول لداود, اذهب وليكن الرب معك. Do not be afraid. The Lord is with you. When the people go to war, they said, "Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord who is with you." لا تخافوا ولا ترتاعوا. اخرجوا للقائهم والرب معكم. You can get horses ready for battle, but it is the Lord who gives victory. Do not be afraid. The Lord is with you. He gives you strength. He delivers you. He gives you victory and salvation. Do not be afraid. The Lord is with you. You can get horses ready for battle, but it is the Lord who gives a victory. Joseph. The Lord was with Joseph, and he was a successful man. Because the Lord was with him, he was a successful man. And his master saw that the Lord was with him. Even his master recognized that whatever he does is not a normal human being doing. He should have a strength from above. He should have favor from God. He should be blessed. This is not a normal man. I can see the Spirit of God work in him. I can see his wisdom. I can see how he success. I can see how he replied. I can see how he took decisions in his life. He's not working alone. The Lord should be with him. And his master saw that the Lord was with him. And that the Lord made all he did to prosper in his hand. The secret of his success, that the Lord was with him. Do not be afraid, the Lord is with you. When you learn a subject, when you go to school, when you are ready to take an exam, do not be afraid, the Lord is with you. When you try to apply for a job or go for interview or take a decision in your life, do not be afraid, the Lord is with you. And He will give you success and prosperity in whatever you do. Do not be afraid, the Lord is with you. The Lord is with you will give you the first thing, strength and deliverance. Second, victory and salvation. The third, success in everything. And care, protection. And the Lord, He is the one who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. Do not fear nor be dismayed. الرب سائر أمامك ويكون معك لا يهمك ولا لا يهملك ولا يتركك لا تخف ولا. The Lord is with you. Do not fear. How a great message for today. I hope all of us can have it and keep it in our heart and remind ourselves with it always. The Lord is with me. Of whom shall I fear? Of what shall I fear? I will fear nobody. The Lord is with me. I will not fear anything because the Lord is with me. And as He was with David and as He was with Moses and Abraham and Jacob and Joseph and all the righteous and the just, He will also be with me and bless me with the strength and deliverance, with victory and salvation, with success in everything, and with care and protection. The Lord is with you. Do not fear. Do not fear. If you don't feel it, if you don't that the Lord is with you, ask Him, Lord, let me feel Your presence with me in everything I do and everywhere I go. Let me feel Your presence. Let me be confident that You are with me and You will not leave me. And even if I am not faithful with You, You will always be faithful with me. حتى رب لو أنا مش أمين معاك أنت تفضل أمين معايا. مش هتسيبني أنت. مش هتسيبني يا رب مش عشان أنا حلو, لكن أنت مش هتسيبني عشان أنت إيه حلو. So when the Lord do good, he does good because He is good. He is righteous, not because I'm good. So His faithfulness is unconditional. His love is unconditional. His goodness is unconditional. And this is the great news that we have it. The Lord is with us. Let us rejoice. Let us praise Him and exalt Him above all forever. Let us praise Him and exalt Him above all forever, because He always with us in everything we do and everywhere we go. The Lord will not leave you and will never forsake you. He always protect you, give you strength. He'll always deliver you, care about you, protect you. That's why every time we pray, we thank You that You have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to Yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour. Let us rejoice. Let us rejoice. مش عارف انتوا ليه مش مبسوطين, بس افرحوا لان الرب معكم. شوف الملاك لما بيقول لها يا عبد, بيقول لمريم ايه؟ السلام لك يا ممتلئة نعمة, في الترانسليشن يقول rejoice O Mary, the Lord is with you. يعني افرح لأن ربنا ايه معاك. انت شايل هم ايه؟ متضايق من ايه؟ مين مضايقك؟ مين منغص عليك عيشتك؟ ولا يهمك, الرب ايه معك. وان كان ربنا معانا نخاف من مين؟ ان كان الرب معنا فمن علينا؟ الرب معي فلا اخشى ماذا يصنع بي الانسان, والرب معي فلا اخشى ما تحمله لي الايه الايام. الرب معي فلا اخشى ماذا يصنع بي الانسان, والرب معي فلا اخشى ما تحمله لي الايام. زي ما قال القديس اوغسطينوس, يا رب انا ما اعرفش, لست ادري ما تحمله لي الايام, ولكن ثقتي انك ايه معي. اخاف من ايه؟ اخاف من ايه؟ اتضايق من ايه؟ ازعل من ايه؟ اعتل هم ايه؟ ده انا اقول له رب ده انت عدت بني اسرائيل 40 سنة في البرية, لم يحتاجوا ولم يعطشوا ولم يجوعوا ولم تبلى ثيابهم ولا دابت احذيتهم. يا رب ده انت عيشت الارملة بلحسة زيت وكويه وشوية دي قد كف, ده انا عندي تلاجة وعندي اكل وعندي كروت وعندي حاجات كتيرة جدا مقارنة بالست الارملة دي. كوار الدقيق لم يفرغ وكوز الزيت لم ينقص, انا خاف من ايه؟ يا رب ده انت وقفت مع داود في حارب جلياط وهزم, انا مش هخاف على عيالي ولا خاف على اولادي ولا خاف على بناتي طالما انت ايه معاهم. سر القوة وسر النجاح وسر الحماية وسر المعونة وسر البركة وسر الفرح هو ايه؟ ربنا معانا. عمان وإيه الذي تفسيره ايه؟ الله معنا. عشان كده احنا فرحانين, وعشان كده في التسبيح هنقول وان كنا فقراء من المال فلنا ضر سمينة اسم الخلاص الذي لربنا يسوع المسيح. ربنا يفرح قلوبكم. يا ريت النهارده كده كل واحد عاتل هم حاجه ولا متضايق من حاجه ولا شايل هم الايام, ولا العيال هيكبروا ازاي ولا يدخلوا المدارس امتى ولا يطلعوا من الجامعه ولون الجامعه ولون مش عارف ايه, ونقعد نكربس دماغنا بحاجات كتيره. نقول له نشكرك يا رب لانك ايه معنا, مش بس معنا, معنا ولن تتركنا, معنا وايه ولن تتركنا مهما حصل. يا رب ثقتي ان انت معايا, يكفيني ان انت معايا, انا مش عايز حاجة تاني, انا لا عايز وعود ولا عايز حاجة من حد, انا يكفيني وعودك ويكفيني حمايتك ويكفيني وجودك معايا. اوعى تسيبني يا رب, اوعى تسيبني يا رب, لانك لو سبتني انا هبقى ايه يعني ورقة شجر في وسط مهب الريح. لكن طول ما انت معايا, طول ما انا مطمن, طول ما انا فرحان, طول ما انا باخد بركات ونعم انا مستاهلهاش, وكل ده بسبب انك ايه معايا. The Lord is with you, do not be afraid. And as the Lord is with us now and he will be with us on the altar, be rejoiced and bring forth to him all your concerns and fear. If you're weak, he will strengthen you. If you're a sinner, he will forgive you and cleanse you. If you need anything, he will provide for you. So rejoice and let us praise him and exalt him above all forever. And glory be to God forever and ever.